नमस्कार। टुडे वी आर इन खानदेश पार्ट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र। बिहाइंड मी इज अ फार्म ऑफ अ मिलेट कॉल्ड जोवार। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू मीट बहिणाबाई, हु कंपोज्ड सिंपल ब्यूटिफुल पोएट्री फुल ऑफ डीप मीनिंग इन द लोकल लैंग्वेज वाइल शी वर्कड ऑन अ फार्म नियर जळगाव इन खानदेश और वाइल एंगेज्ड इन हाउस होल्ड चोर्स एट हर होम इन द चौधरी रेसिडेंस। Although Bahinabai had received no formal education, she had amassed a great deal of experiential knowledge. On the basis of this wisdom, she sang the songs of joys and sorrows of the day-to-day life. Her poetry sprouted in the black soil of Khandesh. It blossomed on its green fields and swayed on its wind. Bahinabai was born in the year 1880 in the Mahajan family of village Asode. At the age of 13, she married and moved to Jalgaon. The original joint family later split and Bahinabai's husband died when she was 30 years old. She was left alone to shoulder the responsibility of her three children and manage the farmlands and her household. But she did not lose courage. She got fully engrossed in the work on her farm and was content in being a single mother to her children. And while she was thus engaged in chores on the farm and at her home, Bahinabai composed poetry and sang songs while she went about her daily life. The season of sowing and rain-loaded wind, the bird takes to wing, calling, sow seed. The season of sowing, thunder rolls in the sky, let it rain, my heart sends out the cry. The season of sowing, soak in the water, O earth, the sack full of seeds stands ready on my hearth. This depiction of emotions of the farmers, such as the rush for sowing following the cry of the rainbird, their anxiety for sufficient rainfall, their relief as the rain pours down, and their hope that the rain will seep into the earth and make it suitable to sow the seeds they have kept ready, comes naturally to Bahinabai. The sowing is completed and Bahinabai is overjoyed to see the seeds sprouting through earth. Her mind is so perceptive that she does not miss the miracle in this common event in nature. She notes this wonder in her poem. The seeds huddle in the earth's cradle, they lie under mud as if covered by rug. The seed swells in the earth, the seedling rises up, the field turns green like a goosebumps scene. See how they sway on wind, seeds from the corns swell. What turn of fortune, God has cast his spell. The crop is now ready for harvest and Bahinabai's imagination takes a new turn. The earth cracks, it's time for reaping, and now lies ahead, harvest's weighing. The harvesting is done, the corn is in the ring. The earth is prepared for the milling of the corn by the oxen, and Bahinabai pleads with the oxen. Make haste, O bullock, powder away the husk, let every corn yield, grains in heaps. Come now, O bullock, lies ahead the winnowing, the wind's going a waste, can't nail it down and pin. This poem paints a quaint picture of Bahinabai hurrying the bullock, for the wind is blowing and she is eager to begin the winnowing. Through her poems, Bahinabai thus depicts the lives of farmers that are interlinked with the cycle of seasons. The winnowing begins and Bahinabai sings, O wind, blow strong and come to the ring. Don't waste time playing with the yearling. Here comes the wind, whispering through miles, gladdening my heart and shaking the leaves. Bahinabai creates a picturesque description of the farmer's concern as the wind disappears at the beginning of winnowing and the rush to complete the tasks as it picks up again. Just as she loves her work in the fields, Bahinabai is equally fond of celebrating festivals. On the New Year Day, she calls on everyone to clean their homes and raise the traditional flag post called Gudi. Now clean your homes and make repairs, paint the walls and raise the flag at doors. She also encourages everyone to forget their differences with the advent of the new year. The year is gone and the hate, with the festival of Padwa, send others your love so great. In another poem, she describes the festival of Akshay Tritiya. आखजीचा आखजीचा मोलाचा सण देखाजी, निंबावरी निंबावरी बांधला छान झोकाजी. The festival of Akhji is so important. On the neem tree, they hung the swings in an instant. She then goes on to describe how the image of Goddess Gauri has been installed in every house, decorated with great care and worshipped. Women invite neighboring women to their homes and they all sing, dance and play games to celebrate the occasion. But even as Bahinabai enjoys the festivities, she is aware of the pending work in the fields. A little rest for a few days and it's back to work in the fields. As per the custom in those days, Bahinabai had not received any training in reading and writing. However, she had a natural gift of imagination. Her friends would often ask her, "We too work in the fields just like you, but how come you can compose such lovely songs?" On this, Bahinabai had composed a song in reply. "My mother, goddess Saraswati, teaches me to sing. Many secrets she's embedded in daughter Bahina's mind." She composed all her poems orally. Her son Sopandev Chaudhary and one of her nephews wrote them down as and when it was possible. But many were lost forever. After Bahinabai's death in 1951, Sopandev showed the manuscript of Bahinabai's poems to Acharya Atre. After reading those poems, Acharya Atre was so impressed that he remarked, "This is pure gold. It would be a mistake to keep away this treasure from readers in Maharashtra." And he went on to publish a collection of these poems titled Songs of Bahinabai. That is how we are able to get acquainted to this spontaneous and characteristic poetry. Bahinabai has composed poems on herself and members of her maternal and matrimonial home. She describes her father as, "My father is the head man, his judgment impartial like a scale." And she calls her mother, "My mother Bhimai I see, like soothing shade of mango tree." Marathi has a long tradition of women's songs. For ages, women have been singing the praise of their maternal homes and complaining about their matrimonial homes. But Bahinabai's songs are more personal and based on her own experiences. She does compare the road to her maternal home to velvet, and the blazing sun of Vaishakh doesn't bother her when travelling there. But her maternal home doesn't seem to be out of bounds for her, unlike other married women of the time. In one of her poems, she sends a message to her mother through a Maina bird that daughter Bahina is on her way, please keep the meal ready. She seems to have enjoyed several visits to her maternal home as she says, "The wind whispers in my ears, message from my mother's home, ask the Lauki river the count of my visits there." She writes about the members of her matrimonial home with equal love. "There sitting in my home is my mother-in-law, her heart full of love and a tearful eye." Bahinabai became a widow at a young age. She shouldered the responsibility of home and her farm with courage. She says, "The lines of my destiny were hidden below my vermilion. Now that it's been wiped off, the lines reveal themselves. Do not examine my hand, O astrologer. Do not come to my home, for I know my destiny." She accepts her fate with fortitude, and despite her grief, she gets ready to bide by her duty. "The bangles are broken, but my wrists are strong. The wedding necklace is gone, but my fidelity is sound. Do not pity me, ladies. Do not feel sorry. I have overcome emotion. I will be wary." Bahinabai is well aware that each person has to survive on his or her own skills and hard work. She says, "Your legs will carry you, you are on your own, you will have to row your boat on your own. They are all selfish, all love is pretense, O traveller on the road, the path is tough indeed." Although Bahinabai was aware of her gift of words, she had no ego. She knew she had not read any big books or scriptures, but believed that the divine had revealed itself to her in the surrounding nature. O Lord Pandurang, your Gita, your Bhagavat assimilates in the rain and sprouts in the earth. I feel your presence in every leaf and blade. The wind alerts me then when you are passing by. She sees the reflection of the Mother Goddess in the boundless universe. When describing this infinite image, she says, बारा गाडे काजळ कुंकू पुरल नाही लेन साती समुद्राच पाणी झाल नाही न्हाण अशी कशी येळी वो माये अशी कशी येळी 12 carts full of vermilion and 12 carts of coal not enough for you. The water of the seven seas not enough for you. How wild you are, O mother, how wild. Trinity of gods, Brahma, Vishnu and Rudra play in your lap. Your nurturing milk of compassion springs a song on my lips. How wild you are, O mother, how wild. Just as Bainabai's poetry reveals her disposition as an admirer of nature, her philosophical poems depict her as a wise saint full of devotion. She advocates pure devotion through her poetry by giving examples from the day-to-day life. One that doesn't sprout cotton wool should not be called a bud. One that doesn't utter the God's name should not be called a mouth. Bainabai composed poetry in her mother tongue of Lewa Ganboli. Although a dialect of Marathi, it is infused with the sweetness of the regional flavor of Khandesh. Bainabai's poetry also has an intrinsic rhythm similar to tribal songs. As such, most of her poems can be sung like songs. When milling the flour on the handmill, she says, Mill, O mill, as you expel the flour, slowly and slowly a song rises from my belly. The use of a dialect for the compositions and the reflection of wisdom earned through experience make Bainabai's poetry extremely natural and inspired. This poem by her is well known. Married life like a pan on the stove, singed fingers first, and then comes bread to the fore. She insists that the man and woman are both responsible in making the married life happy. The married life rests on thinking of the two. It accepts the sorrows but negates joys too. She is fully aware of the capriciousness of the mind. Longings of the mind like cattle in the field, chase them away again and again, they'll return still. Magic of the mind, unique are its ways. It has no antidote like scorpion or snake. Mind's like a bird, how can I define its might? Now it was on earth, now it takes to flight. What kind of a yogi are you that you created such an impulsive mind? Or is it your daydream? She asks God. Bainabai believed in the moral values of universal love and philanthropy. She wished for all strife in the world to end. In her poem, she says, Do not always think of gain. The nature never strives for the self. The crop in the field endures sun and rain, looking forward to satiate men. That's how she imbibes the selflessness from nature. Bainabai not only appreciates the hard-working men and women, but animals and birds as well. She says, The best nest of all builds the weaver bird. Look how she hangs the swing for her nestlings. Her tiny little beak and tiny lips, tiny teeth, God has given you two hands and fingers, 10 at least. Commenting on the soul and its life, she says, There's no end, O soul, to your coming and going. You'll stay here for a while, and they call it living. The breath comes and the breath goes, that's the way you live. What's life and death but the gap in between? She had realized the continuous cycle of life and death. And so she tells herself to live a life of morals that are as high as the sky and a life whose weight is as good as the earth. Live, my soul, live a life whose worth is as high as the sky and as worthy as earth. Barnabai has also characterized some memorable people in her poetry. At times, she has narrated her experiences and weaved some tales. Each of her poems is laden with her experience and adorned with the intensity of her emotions. We have with us today Dr. Madhavi Vaidya, who will tell us more about Barnabai's poetry.
या कार्यक्रमाच्या निमित्तानं मला एका मराठमोळ्या कवयित्रीचं माझ्यावरचं ऋण फेडायचं आहे. ही कवयित्री आहे ना, ती अगदी साधी राहणी आणि उच्च मूल्यांची पखरण आपल्या साहित्यातून करणारी एक निसर्ग कन्या आहे. हाडाची शेतकरी असल्यानं सतत निसर्गाचा सहवास हिला लाभला आणि म्हणूनच ती सहजता प्रसन्नता तिच्या साहित्यात सुद्धा आली. तिचं साहित्य म्हणजे साहित्य विश्वातला एक झुळझुणारा नादावून टाकणारा झराच आहे असं म्हटलं तर वावग होणार नाही. एका अशिक्षित बाईनं इतकी विपुल आणि मूल्याधारित काव्य निर्मिती केली तरी कशी, प्रश्न पडतो ना आपल्याला. अरे संसार संसार मन वढाय वढाय यासारखी कितीतरी गाणी सहज गुणगुणता गुणगुणता त्यांच्या तोंडून निघाली. कुणालाही न घेता आलेला मनाचा ठाव तिने अगदी सहजपणे घेतला. कित्येक व्यक्ती हुशार असतात, पण हुशार असणारी व्यक्ती शहाणी असतेच किंवा शहाणी असेल हे मात्र संभवत नाही. पण बहिणाबाई चौधरी दोन्ही होत्या. त्या चतुरही होत्या, चाणाक्षही होत्या, निरक्षीर विवेक करण्या इतक्या बुद्धिमान होत्या, पण अत्यंत शहाण्या सुरत्याही होत्या. हे सर्व त्यांचं साहित्य वाचल्यावर आपल्या मनावर जास्त जास्त ठसतच जात. सोपान देवानी म्हणजे त्यांच्या मुलांनी एकदा त्यांना विचारलं, तू शेतात कष्टाची कामं करतेस, तुझी नजर तर जमिनीकडे आणि तुला हे विचार सुचतात तरी कसे? त्यावर बहिणाबाई उतरल्या, धरित्रीच्या आरशामध्ये मी सर्ग पाहते बाप्पा. एकदा काय झालं, एक योगी आला आणि तो योगी म्हणाला, तुझ्या तोंडी माहेरचं गुणगान सतत असत, तुला मी विचारतो, माझं माहेर माहेर सदा गाणं तुझ्या ओठी, माझं माहेर माहेर सदा गाणं तुझ्या ओठी, मग माहेरून आली सासर आले कशासाठी. ती मुलगी असते ना, ती असते डोहाळ तुली, सासूरवाशी. आणि ही सासूरवाशीण त्या योग्यानं म्हणते, देरे देरे योग्या ध्यान ऐक काय मी सांगते, देरे देरे योग्या ध्यान ऐक काय मी सांगते, लेकीच्या माहेरासाठी माय सासरी नांदते. असा त्यांचा हजर जबाबीपणा. आपल्या शेतावर खूप माया असणारी, अगदी साधी भोळीच पण आस्तिक्य भाव मनात जपणारी, पण अतिशय प्रतिभावान कवयित्री म्हणून बहिणाबाई चौधरी होत्या. म्हणूनच त्या म्हणू शकल्या, सोन्या रुपयानं मढला मारवाड्याचा बालाजी, सोन्या रुपयानं मढला मारवाड्याचा बालाजी, शेतकऱ्याचा इठोबा पाना फुला मधीराजी. सर्वत्र देव सारखाच असतो नाही का, पण माणूस मात्र श्रीमंती आणि गरिबी असा दुजा भाव त्यात करतो. बहिणाबाईच्या साहित्यातून अखंडपणे मानवतावादाचा स्रोत पाझरताना दिसतो. माणसाच्या काळ्या कर्तुदींनी त्या अतिशय व्यथित होतात आणि म्हणतात, अरे मानसा मानसा तुझी नियत बेकार, अरे मानसा मानसा तुझी नियत बेकार, तुझ्याहून बर गोठ्यातलं जनावर. किंवा माणसाच्या अहंकारी वृत्तीविषयी बोलताना त्या म्हणतात, अरे मी कोण मी कोण मी पणाची मरे माय, अरे मी कोण मी पणाची मरे माय, देखा हिची कशी तरा सोता सोतालेच खाया। आणि माणूस की विसरलेल्या माणसालाच त्या एक फार मोठा गहन असा प्रश्न विचारतात, अरे मानसा मानसा कधी वशील माणूस। माणसाच्या अंगात असणारा हा येडेपणा असाच राहणार आहे का? हा भाव व्यक्त करताना त्या सहजपणे कागदाची उपमा देतात आणि सांगतात, मानसापरी माणूस राहतो रे येडा जना, मानसापरी माणूस राहतो रे येडा जना, अरे होतो छापीसनी कोरा कागद शहाणा। इतकं बारीक निरीक्षण आपल्या काव्यात सहजपणे गोवणारी ही कवयित्री अद्भुतच म्हणायला पाहिजे, नाही का? अलौकिक म्हणायला पाहिजे। माणसाच्या जीवनात सुख येत, त्याच्याच बरोबर दुःखही येत, पण दोन्हीचा स्वीकार करताना माणसानं आपलं स्वतःच दुःख तळघरात कोंडलं पाहिजे आणि आपलं सुख मात्र हंड्या झुमर दारी लावून साजरं केलं पाहिजे, असंच त्यांचं मत आहे। जन्म आणि मृत्यू या माणसाच्या जीवनातल्या अटळ घटना आहेत, त्या स्वीकारताना सुद्धा आपण स्थितप्रज्ञ वृत्तीनंच स्वीकारायला हव्यात असं त्यांना मनोमन वाटत। एखाद्या भाषाशास्त्राच्या पंडिताही वाटाव्यात असे भाषाशास्त्र विषयक नियम सुद्धा त्या अगदी सहज सांगू शकतात। दंत्य, ओष्ठ्य, तालव्य अशी कितीतरी उच्चारांची उदाहरणं अगदी चपखलपणे आपल्या काव्यातून मांडतात। आत्या, बाय, तात, काका अशी नात्याची जंत्री देता देता त्या सासू या मजेदार नात्याकडे वळतात आणि म्हणतात, जीजी म्हणता म्हणता झाले जिभेले निवारा, जीजी म्हणता म्हणता झाले जिभेले निवारा, सासू म्हणता म्हणता गेला तोंडातून वारा। त्यांच्या सर्वच साहित्याला एक हास्याची मनोहारी किनार लाभलेली आहे। म्हणजे त्यांच्या साहित्याचं वर्णनच करायचं झालं ना तर त्यांनीच म्हटल्याप्रमाणे असं करावं लागेल, आला आला रायरंग, आला आला रायरंग करी लोकांचं रंजन, हसविता हसविता घाली डोयात अंजन। अगदी अशीच त्यांची कविता ही आहे। आपलं म्हणणं त्या अत्यंत रंजक पद्धतीनं आपल्या समोर मांडतात। त्यांच्या अनेक म्हणी बघितल्या ना तरी ही गोष्ट अगदी विशेषत्वानं लक्षात येते। उदाहरणार्थ एक म्हण बघा, ह पोट म्हणे भरलं पोत, पोट म्हणे भरलं पोत, जीभ म्हणे तुझं काय जात, म्हणी कशासाठी याचंही उत्तर त्या देतात। म्हणणारानं म्हण केली, म्हणणारानं म्हण केली जाणणार आले अक्कल आली, किंवा त्या एका उदाहरणाद्वारे माणसाच्या वर्तणुकीवर नेमकं बोट ठेवतात। पाही सनी रे लोकांचे व्यवहार खोटे नाटे, पाही सनी रे लोकांचे व्यवहार खोटे नाटे, तवा बोरी बाभईच्या अंगावर आले काटे। खरोखर काय अलौकिक असं ते काव्य, इतक्या कमी शब्दात जीवनाचा सार आपल्या समोर ठेवणाऱ्या बहिणाबाई चौधरी त्यांच्या प्रतिभेला आणि त्यांना मी नम्रतापूर्वक वंदन करते।
Do read the poetry of this gifted poet from Khandesh in its original form. Tell us what you liked about her poetry. We shall meet again next Friday to discuss a regional novel. Until then, keep reading.